on, it looks pretty good. I'll make your drop along the western slope there, along that far edge along the road.
I see it, John. Long road. You'll drop in 30 second intervals.
71, want as long a fire line as you can make. We better hold it on the west.
Here in California today, there's a new air tanker flying, the Grumman S2 Tracker, replacing the TBMs and the B-17s, the planes from World War II that have served so well and so long in the attack on wildland fires. Just a few in number today, the S2 soon will become the predominant air tanker in California, providing the State Division of Forestry with the ability to respond rapidly to wildland fires, to contain fires that each year threaten thousands of acres of timber and more thousands of acres of California recreation and rangeland. By the start of the fire season next year, 17 S2s will be operational and on the line in California to replace all single-engine tankers. The S2 has proven itself an impressive air tanker. Not only is it one engine safer than the TBM, today's workhorse tanker, but the S2 can drop 200 more gallons of retardant at a time, get to a fire faster, and then stay over that fire longer if necessary. And if parts are needed to keep it flying, they're readily available. Not so with the 30-year-old TBM. During the past 5 years, the Division of Forestry has attacked almost 4,000 fires from the air with World War II aircraft, dropping more than 17 million gallons of fire retardants. In the years ahead, the S2 Tracker, two engines safe, reliable, and fast, will provide California with a fire attack capability second to none, continuing the air attack on wildland fires to contain them until ground fire crews arrive at that mountain slope, that remote canyon, that hillside where no one will ever build a road.
Okay, 71, good drop. I'm going to bring Woody in with 70 and continue the line. Get on back, get another load of mud, 71. Come on back out. Orbit when you do and I'll pick you up. Woody, let's make your drop along the same line, but we'll kick it out further.
Even with a load, we can still carry it on a single engine. By getting rid of our load, of course, we're super light. Single engine performance is fantastic on this airplane. It has no bad habits. It's as honest a flying airplane as I've been in. For this job, I would say it's probably the safest airplane in the whole show at the present time. I think it's the best one we've got. Plus, it's yellow. I like it. The fire was pretty much on the sides of the canyon, a lot of smoke, and it was the downdraft of the wind was taking the smoke down into the canyon and out the other side. Well, they wanted to drop down on the side of the canyon wall a little ways, so I came over the drop down in the canyon behind the smoke. There was plenty of room in there, but there was an awful downdraft, but the airplane, he got fire on this thing. It's fantastic. So it drug me out of a spot that I stuck myself into. I shouldn't have. This happens and this kind of work. I don't guess there's any way you'll ever learn at all. But this thing will sure get you out of a tight spot if you get into one.
Grumman first designed the S-2 to meet a Navy requirement for an anti-submarine aircraft, one that would combine both search and attack capabilities. Grumman was awarded a contract for one aircraft in June 1950, and the first flight was made 2.5 years later. The first planes entered Navy service in February 1954. S-2s have also been supplied to the Royal Netherlands Navy, to Italy, Japan, Argentina, Brazil, and to the Royal Canadian Navy. Today, in a new peaceful role, they serve the people of California. This year, 12 S-2s will be online in California as air tankers, fighting wildland fires throughout the state, responding rapidly to the fires that threaten range, forest, and recreational land in both northern and southern California. An additional 5 S-2s will be added to the air tanker fleet by the start of the 1975 wildland fire season.
As far as the S-2 working as a fire tanker, it seems to be probably the best performing airplane that I've used on fires. I've been at it 14 years now, starting our 15th year. Turnaround time with this airplane, of course they load them pretty quick with the big pumps and whatnot. They load you in about, right around 2 minutes. And we get consistent 4 and 5 minute turnarounds from touchdown to takeoff again. So that's a good factor. We can haul more loads that way in a day's time on a sustained fire. Why, we lose very little time on the ground. It's a real performant little airplane. Safety wise, we can haul out of there with a single engine, even with a load, we can get out. Climb with a load and single engine. We climb as good with one engine up to pretty good altitude. 7,000 or 8,000 feet, you can still climb single engine and do a pretty good job of climbing. It's a real good point for our type of work, because if we should lose an engine out there in the canyons and whatnot, why we're able to get out of there. Some airplanes you can't. I think the S-2 is probably the safest airplane to fly for this type of work.
Meet the Avenger, the TBF, a single-engine, three-place folding mid-wing monoplane equipped for use as a torpedo plane, as a horizontal or glide bomber with a capacity of 400 500-pound bombs, and as a scout or smoke layer. The TBF is designed to take off from or land on a carrier and can be launched by catapult. When the prop has been pulled through to clear the cylinders, the hand crank is engaged and the starter brought up to half speed. This saves the batteries, which may be run down quickly, particularly in cold weather. After checking prop control in full low pitch, the battery switch is placed in on position, and the fuel tank selector valve turned to center main. The electric fuel pump is switched on and fuel pressure brought up to 7 to 9 pounds per square inch. Next, the starter is energized for 15 seconds. And at the same time, the electric primer is operated for 3 to 5 seconds. The throttle is set to 1/3 open and the ignition switch turned to both. Finally, after making sure the propeller is clear, the starter is engaged until the engine runs smoothly. As soon as the engine starts,